Magandang araw, Kapamilya. Today is Tuesday of the fifth week of Lent. Our Mass presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphon. Wait for the Lord, be strong. Be stout-hearted and wait for the Lord.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. Grant us, we pray, O Lord, perseverance in obeying your will, that in our days the people dedicated to your service may grow in both merit and number. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of Numbers. From Mount Hor, the children of Israel set out on the Red Sea road to bypass the land of Edom. But with their patience worn out by the journey, the people complained against God and Moses. Why have you brought us up from Egypt to die in this desert, where there is no food or water? We are disgusted with this wretched food. In punishment, the Lord sent among the people seraph serpents, which bit the people so that many of them died. Then the people came to Moses and said, "We have sinned in complaining against the Lord and you. Pray the Lord to take the serpents away from us." So Moses prayed for the people. And the Lord said to Moses, "Make a seraph and mount it on a pole, and whoever looks at it after being bitten will live." Moses accordingly made a bronze serpent and mounted it on a pole. And whenever anyone who had been bitten by a serpent looked at the bronze serpent, he lived. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. O Lord, hear my prayer and let me cry and let my cry come to you.
O Lord, hear my prayer and let my cry come to you.
O Lord, hear my prayer and let my cry come to you. Hide not your face from me in the day of my distress. Incline your ear to me in the day when I call. Answer me speedily.
O Lord, hear my prayer and let my cry come to you.
The nations shall revere your name, O Lord, and all the kings of the earth your glory. When the Lord has rebuilt Zion and appeared in his glory, when he has regarded the prayer of the destitute and not despised their prayer.
O Lord, hear my prayer and let my cry come to you.
Let this be written for the generation to come, and let his future creatures praise the Lord. The Lord looked down from his holy height. From heaven he beheld the earth, to hear the groaning of the prisoners, to release those doomed to die.
O Lord, hear my prayer and let my cry come to you.
Verse before the Gospel. Glory and praise to you, O Christ. The seed is the word of God. Christ is the sower. All who come to him will live forever. Glory and praise to you, O Christ.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to the Pharisees, "I am going away and you will look for me, but you will die in your sin." So the Jews said, "He is not going to kill himself, is he? Because he said, 'Where I am going, you cannot come.'" He said to them, "You belong to what is below, I belong to what is above. You belong to this world, but I do not belong to this world. This is why I told you that you will die in your sins. For if you do not believe that I am, you will die in your sins." So they said to him, "Who are you?" Jesus said to them, "What I told you from the beginning, I have much more to say about you in condemnation. But the one who sent me is true, and what I heard from him, I tell the world." They did not realize that he was speaking to them of the Father. So Jesus said to them, When you lift up the Son of Man, then you will realize that I am, and that I do nothing on my own, but I say only what the Father taught me. The one who sent me is with me. He has not left me alone, because I always do what is pleasing to him. Because he spoke this way, many came to believe in him. My dear brothers and sisters, the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
You know, this whole week, no, we will be reading from the Gospel of John, as we've been reading since last week. No, but here you have really, in a sense, Christ carrying conversation with the people. No, and the thing that you will see in the coming days is that Christ now is beginning to tell people who he is. So it's really a very deep discussion or conversation, if you wish, no, about his identity, who he is, and where he came from. So remember, this is the other big issue, no, with the Lord, no. So here at the ending of this gospel, you heard that because of the way he talked, many people believed in him. But later on, as you will see, no, as we go through the gospels this coming week, no, all the way to Saturday, actually, no, people now will begin to, in a sense, in quotation marks, be offended by what he's saying, and then towards the end of this week, they want to stone him already, no. So here I think, no, that is the context, no, and maybe that is the first point that I invite you to reflect on, no, that here Christ now begins to speak about the truth of who he is, and I think he speaks about the truth of who he is, in a sense being aware of the consequences of this, no, that eventually, remember, this is one of the issues that will lead him to his passion and cross. And yet the Lord speaks about it very plainly and clearly, no? So the first point that we will reflect on. Now, the second point is that he really talks about this identity. If you notice, he says, I am twice, no? And then remember that in the second I am that he says, no, when the Son of Man, you lift up the Son of Man, that is a reference to the cross and resurrection, no? And then the third point that we will reflect on is to realize now that the role of loving obedience, no, in Christ fulfilling his mission. Siguro itong tatlong punto to, makita natin sa linggong darating na ang Panginoon ngayon ay magsasalita na at kakausapin niya ang mga tao para sabihin ang kanyang pinagmulan at kung sino siya. Yung kanyang malalim na ugnayan sa Ama, no, yun ang pag-uusapan niya itong linggong ito. Pero yun yung unang konteksto natin. Yung pangalawang konteksto ay makikita natin sa tapos nitong ebanghelyo ngayong araw. Sabi dito, dahil sa kanyang pamamaraan ng pananalita, marami ang naniwala sa kanya. Pero hanggang darating na araw, itong linggo ito, palalim ng palalim, ano, yung kanyang pakikipag-usap. At sa katapusan, yung mga tao hindi matanggap yung kanyang sinasabi ka. Gusto nilang batuhin siya, no? So ito yung konteksto ng pagninilay natin ngayong araw at itong mga darating na araw sa linggong ito. So the first point is that, you know, this whole Christ talking about his identity, no? What really for me what is amazing here, especially as we read throughout the week, no, is that how despite the fact that the Lord knew that this will get him into trouble, you know, he did not back down, no? But he continued to clearly tell people who he is, and where he came from, and his deep union with the Father. Remember, this is one of the major issues against Christ. No, his claim to divinity, to being the Son of God or the Son of Man. No, so here you see, perhaps it is a good example for us, and also a good example, of course, to emulate and to reflect on ourselves. How, in a sense, how firm were we in terms of our identity and integrity? How much integrity and identity are we really embracing and also standing on? And again, the Tagalog word is manindigan. Sa ano ba ang ating pinaninindigan tungkol sa ating pagkatao? At yung pagkatao natin na nakaugat sa ating ugnayan sa Diyos, sa ating relasyon sa Diyos. Tayo ba ay namumuhay ng ganun? Hindi lang natin sasabihin na tayo lang ay tinawag na Kristiyanong pangalan, pero yung pamumuhay natin ay ibang-iba, no? Pero ano yung ating pinaninindigan na pagkatao at pagiging Kristiyano? okay, what is it that we are willing to stand by in terms of our integrity, no, and our identity as Christians? In the same way that the Lord in the Gospels this week would show that, no, that firmness and that really that ability to stick to His word, no, and to stick to His identity, and He will speak His truth, no? That is His word, the truth of who He is and His origins, no? So siguro itong unang punto, no, it's important for us to, in a sense, to do some examination, so to speak, no? Because I think this is very important in our following of Christ, no? Our paninindigan in terms of our identity as Christians, no? And then the second point is, again, here, it prepares us for Holy Week. Remember in the Old Testament, when again, we mentioned this a lot, no? when Moses asked Yahweh, who will I say sent me? And then the burning bush, no? Yahweh said, tell them I am sent you. And therefore, the use of that I am is a reference to God. And Christ uses it here in today's gospel twice. No? And I think this is, again, something that we would like to sort of assess. No? Because the I am now will eventually lead to the revelation of the divinity of Christ in the mystery of the cross and resurrection. Because this is what we are preparing for. As I always say, the whole of Lent is a preparation to once more renew in us the grace and the mystery of the cross and resurrection. And here Christ refers to that, no? That when you raise up the Son of Man, you will realize that I am, no? The Lord is saying that my divinity will be proven in the mystery of the cross and resurrection. And Moses, in the first reading, no, you have reference to that, no? To the raising up, no? Just as Moses, remember in John chapter 3, the Lord will say, just as Moses lifted up the serpent in the desert, so will the Son of Man be lifted up. So again, it is now more and more preparing us, no, to be ready, to prepare ourselves, to be ready to renew the cross and resurrection. Siguro yung pangalawang punto na yan, no? Gaano katunay, gaano kalalim ang misteryo ng krus at muling pagkabuhay sa ating pang-araw-araw na buhay. Hindi lamang pag Semana Santa, hindi lamang pag nagre-retreat tayo, pero sa pang-araw-araw na buhay natin, gaano kabuhay at gaano katotoo ang misteryo at biyaya ng krus at muling pagkabuhay? Do we live out the pattern of the cross and resurrection in our lives, in our day-to-day lives? And perhaps to ask ourselves, not just do we live it out, but how? How? In the little things, no? I think it is always in the little things of how we live it out in the day-to-day. Yung sa pang-araw-araw na maliliit na bagay ng ating pamumuhay, tayo ba ay binubuhay natin ang biyaya ng krus at muling pagkabuhay sa ating pang-araw-araw na mga gawain? And then the third and last point is that here now, oh, it's also like a very powerful preparation for Holy Week. Remember what we would always reflect on, that suffering per se is not salvific, but what transformed the suffering of Christ was that it was a suffering offered in loving obedience, in loving obedience. And Christ talks about that a lot here, that I will not do anything except if it comes from the Father. Everything that I say comes from the Father. So in a sense that not just union, but the obedience to what the Father wants Him to do. And this will be put to the test in the agony in the garden. And Christ, in quotation marks, succeeds, passes the test with flying colors. The loving obedience that transforms or that transformed the passion and suffering, no, of Christ. And eventually the death on the cross. Because it was offered in loving obedience, the suffering becomes a perfect sacrifice. Siguro yan ang isa rin natin biyayang unawain sa paghahanda natin sa darating na Semana Santa, na ang malalim na kaugnayan ng Panginoon ay talagang nakaugat sa mapagmahal na pagtalima. Sapagkat yan ang magmasasabi natin, yan ang magbibigay ng malalim na kahulugan at biyaya sa pagpapasakit ng Panginoon. At yung kanyang pagpapasakit sa kanyang pasyon at krus ay magiging perpektong pag-aalay sa Diyos dahil sa mapagmahal na talima. Kaya tanungin din natin ang ating sarili, no, sa araw-araw. do we live our lives in loving obedience? And again, in the little things, in the little things. Nabubuhay ba tayo ng may mapagmahal na pagtalima sa lahat ng ginagawa natin sa araw-araw? Today, let us pray that our prayer, our reflections, our coming together in our masses this week will prepare us for the coming Holy Week. Let us ask the Lord to grant us this grace and to send us His Spirit. In the name of the Father, of the Son, of the Holy Spirit. Amen. In faith, let us pray to the Father who, through the sufferings of His Son, has saved us from all condemnation.
That God's people may succeed in spreading the good news of salvation to the world, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That a growing number of people may accept Jesus as their Savior, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who are earnestly searching for the truth may find Jesus, who is the light shining in the darkness of life, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. And let us remember all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. For all this we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
We offer you, O Lord, the sacrifice of conciliation, that being moved to compassion, you may both pardon our offenses and direct our wavering hearts through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For through the saving passion of your Son, the whole world has received a heart to confess the infinite power of your majesty. Since by the wondrous power of the cross, your judgment on the world is now revealed and the authority of Christ crucified. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks, as in exaltation we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Accept, Father Most Holy, all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
And together now, let us spend a few moments of silence. And together, let us offer our prayer of humble faith and hope.
Merciful and compassionate Father, we humbly come before you in faith and hope. Grant us your grace and guidance as we emerge from this pandemic. We thank you for the blessings that saw us through the challenges of the past years. Reward those who selflessly served and continue to serve our many needs. Console those who suffered. Heal the sick. Grant eternal rest to those who died. May we draw inspiration from our collective and individual experiences. Let our hearts burn within us to build a world closer to your kingdom of justice, truth, equality, peace, joy, faith, hope, compassion, and love. May each of us be a bright candle to remind us that light will overcome darkness and never the other way around. We pray for our nation. Give us the courage and inspiration to relentlessly take part in the project of building a nation that our founding fathers envisioned over a century ago, and to which succeeding generations offered their lives in dedicated service, some to the point of martyrdom. Heroes, also Filipinos, may continue to work for freedom and someday truly be free. Grant all these through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Our Lady of the Immaculate Conception, Patroness of the Philippines,
pray for us.
Our Lady, Help of all Christians and Health of the Sick,
pray for us.
Our Lady of Fatima,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel,
pray for us.
Saint Roch,
pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz,
pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod,
pray for us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus,
have mercy on us.
Santo Niño de Cebu,
have mercy on us.
Divine Mercy,
have mercy on us. And let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that ever seeking what is divine, we may be worthy to approach these heavenly gifts through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless us, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Maraming pong salamat and have a good day ahead. Thank you.